Obviously, we're building the evidence for DNA dual analysis. We think it's incontrovertible that getting living intact cancer cells will give you additional information beyond the circulating tumor DNA.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Angle Chief Executive Andrew Newland. Andrew, very good to speak with you. You've announced successful results for your dual ctDNA and ctcDNA workflow on the Illumina platform for the first time. Can you tell us about the new data and the significance?
Yes, well, we're really happy. We've been working for some time now to see if we can get an Illumina end-to-end solution in place. It's taken us over 6 months to resolve a number of technical issues, but we're delighted that we've done that. And so this differs from the work that we previously presented, which was using a third-party DNA kit on the Illumina sequencing. This is Illumina end-to-end, Illumina DNA kit, actually a specialist lung cancer kit, and Illumina sequencing. And what we're pleased about is we've got some very strong data for lung cancer. And specifically, what we've shown is that in a 27-patient study, there were 8 patients who had been diagnosed with cancer but had no treatment. And in every single one of those, so 100% of those, we identified actionable DNA variants in the circulating tumor cells, which you can only get from Parsortix, that part of the sample, and which were not in the ctDNA. And in those patients which had been treated and were either still on treatment, which obviously would reflect results, or had were in between treatments, we found that in 90% of those patients, we similarly found actionable clinical variants in the circulating tumor cell DNA, which were not present in the ctDNA. So this is this adds to the evidence that we've already shown of the importance of analyzing circulating tumor cells. And what's different here is it's specialist lung cancer panel and it's end-to-end Illumina solution.
Andrew, what's the significance of this for Angle?
Well, obviously, we're building the evidence for DNA dual analysis. We think it's incontrovertible that getting living intact cancer cells will give you additional information beyond the circulating tumor DNA, which is fragments of dead cells. And this adds to that. But the big significance for Angle, which we've been working towards, is the end-to-end Illumina solution. And Illumina is pretty excited about this. In fact, so excited that they've allocated their entire webinar for the European Association of Cancer Research Conference, which is coming up. They've got a webinar on the 6th of February, and they've allocated the whole thing to Angle's presentation of these results because they can see the importance of it. And we believe that that's a very strong start to a new co-marketing program between Illumina and Angle to bring this to market. And the relevance to Angle is Illumina is a big player in the sequencing market. They've got 23,000 sequencing systems which are in the market, and they've been sold to 9,500 customers. All these customers could benefit from buying a Parsortix system and using that to recover the sample and then extend their analysis from ctDNA to cover both ctDNA and circulating tumor cells. So that's why we're very, very happy about it.
Andrew, there's been intense interest in AI this week. While I have you, is there any relevance of AI and the recent news to liquid biopsy?
Oh, that's an interesting one. Yes, there's been a lot of news about AI. Obviously, artificial intelligence has a relevance in liquid biopsy. And in fact, we're already using it in a couple of places. So we use it as part of our image analysis when we're looking at proteins on cells under a microscope to detect different aspects there and codify the cells efficiently. And we're also beginning to use it in molecular signatures, which is where it's been used mainly in ctDNA. So ctDNA kind of spews out a lot of fragmented data, and artificial intelligence is being used to try and bring that together and get sense from it. But I guess we've seen in computing the effect of Moore's law and how computers become smaller, cheaper, faster, etc., very fast, progressively becoming a commodity. And the same thing happens with sequencing and with artificial intelligence. And I guess the DeepSeek news is really showing what we kind of could have already expected, which is that the cost will get lower and lower as people get more efficient with these things. And consequently, both sequencing and AI companies will progressively need to add content. So they need to acquire content so that they keep themselves differentiated and keep their margins high. And I think that when the industry looks at the whole process for liquid biopsy, we know that, you know, obviously having good quality sequencing is critical. So can AI be very important in the process. But it's absolutely critical that you start with a good sample in the first place. I mean, the old maxim in computing was garbage in equals garbage out. So if you have a poor sample to start off with, you're not going to get very far. We increasingly believe that the industry is going to recognize that you actually do have to have the best possible sample on which to do all this sequencing and AI. And therefore, you know, eventually we think the whole industry will realize the need to adopt a Parsortix-based sample so that they can get intact living cancer cells that are spreading the disease rather than focusing on byproduct of the disease or the immune system. So we see all of the AI stuff as really playing towards angles such that the industry will actually focus in on the best sample, which is what we believe we offer.
Andrew, congratulations again on today's news. Thank you very much for speaking with us.
Thank you very much.
That's ANGLE Chief Executive Andrew Newland.